So what you are looking at in front of you is called a Big Dog recovery rope. It's made by Bulldog. This thing is super cool. It's 1.5 inches in diameter, and it's rated up to 63,000 pounds worth of brake strength. So the type of scenario where you would use this is if you're pulling someone out of mud or sand, or where they're really bogged down and you need to build up kinetic energy to try to remove them. Typically, if you have a toe strap, the flat style toe straps, which I also carry, I have a 4-inch toe strap. It's rated at like 30,000 pounds. Whenever you're trying to pull someone out, you have to make sure that the strap is relatively tight. Otherwise, what you end up doing is you end up driving forward. As soon as that toe strap gets tight, it doesn't give at all. And what ends up happening is it ends up jarring both the vehicle that you're pulling and your vehicle. And what you can actually do is break the vehicles. You can tear a bumper off. You can actually damage the frame. There's a lot of scenarios that a toe strap, though it's better than nothing, might actually negatively affect everything at the end of the day. More important than any of that, you don't get the same type of kinetic force you get with a kinetic type recovery rope. So this rope is massive. Again, 1.5 inches in diameter. This thing really acts as a big giant rubber band. So whenever you're pulling someone out, it stretches and then it pulls that energy back and it retracts itself, which helps pull somebody out. But more importantly, it doesn't have that jarring instant tug nature that you might see with your traditional toe strap. This again is going to expand and then it's going to contract. So kinetic ropes aren't new. A lot of manufacturers make them. You do want to be careful and avoid the extremely cheap ones. If you find one for $100 that's 1.5 inches thick, it's probably not going to be a good quality rope. And the last thing you want is to get something like this, expect it to work, and then it not work when you need it most. So I would definitely recommend you get a high quality kinetic rope. Now, I've always carried around two recovery straps. One's a 30-foot by 4-inch and another one's a 30-foot by 3-inch. One's rated at 16,000 pounds and one's rated at about 30,000 pounds. And I've never had an issue using them. However, newer technologies such as kinetic ropes like this are much better. They're better for both vehicles, the recovery vehicle and the one being recovered. And the engineering behind a rope like this and how it's designed to work will make the entire process easier and quicker. So that's the reason why I have added this specific recovery system to my truck. There have been multiple times when I've used my straps to pull out trucks, anywhere from small pickup trucks all the way up to large semi trucks. And if you've watched my channel for a while, you've probably seen some of those videos. I have them actually in my video log still, so you can hunt back for them and check out what I'm talking about. This type of setup is a very good setup, but what you want to make sure is that you get a rope that is capable of supporting the weight of whatever you're going to be towing. Now, they have a couple sizes that are smaller than this and a couple sizes that are larger than this. For my application, I thought 1.5 inches in diameter would be perfect. This one, again, has a 63,000 pound brake strength, and because of its elasticity and how it's designed to work, you want to make sure that you have as much strength as possible for your application. What you can probably also tell is that it's relatively large. This doesn't take up a small footprint inside of your vehicle. It's going to be a larger footprint, so I don't recommend getting the largest rope you can find simply because you may not have the room for it, because it does take up a lot of room. This specific one comes with a bag. I also got a couple of other accessories that will really aid in recovery whenever you have to use them. So here is the bag, and I also have a couple soft shackles. So soft shackles are absolutely great to have. They are stronger than steel shackles. They work better. They're more flexible. They get into areas that you may not be able to get a steel shackle. These are incredibly large ones. They're about 1.25 inches in diameter. It's 5/8 inch rope shackle, which means when this thing stretches out, it's going to be about 5/8 inch. 61,700 pound brake strength. Anyways, guys, I didn't want to use these in a fake demonstration just to demonstrate how they work. I wanted to make sure that whenever I do use these, I'm using them in a way that is meaningful. So again, these are going to be added to my recovery setup. I'm not going to get rid of my flat straps because there are scenarios where those come in handy, but I will probably replace one of them in the vehicle with this one, and I'll put the other one in another vehicle. Again, soft shackles. This is actually a very, very large soft shackle compared to some, but it does have an incredibly high brake strength. Again, 61,700 pounds. Soft shackle, kinetic recovery rope is the way to go. Whether you get the Bulldog brand, whether you get other brands that are out there, as long as you get a high quality setup, I always encourage people to go to etrailer.com. They support my channel, they're a sponsor of my channel, and they have a very solid product with a very good reputation. Bulldog also makes winches, so if you're looking for a winch, they also carry the Bulldog lineup of winches, as well as Super Winch and several other recovery type products. But they did provide this rope to me because I was talking to them about recovery ropes and kinetic ropes and things like that. And I thought it would be important to show you guys what I'm adding to my recovery setup, because this can help in all sorts of scenarios. A lot of people that go RVing get stuck in the mud. A lot of people that have truck campers get stuck in the mud. RVs are heavy. There are scenarios where you think the ground might be hard enough because your tow vehicle can get on it, but the minute your skinnier tires on your RV get on it, they sink in and you're buried. And that's really where something like this can help you out, even if you're the one that needs recovering. So keep that in mind. Just because you don't plan on going out and helping other people recover doesn't mean you may not find yourself in a situation that you need recovering. And carrying something like this in the front storage compartment of your RV and the back of your truck and your toolbox can definitely aid in that effort. Anyways, guys, I will put a link in the description of this video if this is something you're interested in. As soon as I get the opportunity to use this in a real way, I will record it so you guys see specifically how these kinetic ropes work and how effective they really are. Guys, if you haven't had a chance, please take a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you again very soon.